You've heard the commercials. Eat this yogurt. It's full of probiotics. They're super good for you, more specifically your gut. But have you ever heard of prebiotics? Turns out they might be good for you too. Robert Thompson works at the Stress Physiology Laboratory at the Department of Integrative Physiology at CU Boulder. Thompson's been studying these lesser-known dietary building blocks.
So prebiotics are thought currently to be non-digestible fibers that we as humans cannot digest, but the bacteria can feed on them, and they're thought to be food for these bacteria, certain bacteria.
Thompson has been feeding the prebiotics to lab animals and finding some pretty interesting stuff that could apply to humans.
It benefits us, and because these bacteria that can eat these specific prebiotics that we studied are thought to be stress protective gut bacteria, so that would benefit us as the host.
His lab normally looks at stress. What kind of things stress us out? What are the negative consequences of stress? What can stop those consequences? Things like diet and exercise, Thompson says, play a role. Thompson's study found that those fibrous foods helped animals recover from stress the same way a lot of us do. Sleep.
Which was surprising to me, but it was there and exciting. So the animals that we studied slept better at a younger age. They had more consolidated, non-rapid eye movement sleep, which is thought to be the restful and restorative type sleep. The deep sleep is another term for it.
Thompson thinks the diet helped REM sleep because animals that got prebiotics had a more complex and healthier bacteria biome in their guts. While it's too soon to say if a diet with high-fiber foods like chicory, artichokes, raw garlic, leeks, or onions will help humans.
I definitely have been eating more salad, I can tell you that. I've always liked salad, but I was like, well, I don't think this is going to hurt.
Thompson says that's something that he and some colleagues are looking into.
Thanks for listening. This is Andres Belton reporting for CU Lab R.A.T.S., podcast produced by Strategic Relations and Communications for the University of Colorado Boulder.